Hello everyone, welcome to Viksam channel. It is an educational channel for plus one, plus two, JEE and NEET aspirants. And let me first introduce myself. I am Ms. Rajeshwari Bhuiya and I am a veterinary student and also a student of the founders of this channel. Let me first introduce you to them. Meet Sumalata ma'am. She is a physics teacher. And meet Vikram sir. Sir is a chemistry teacher. And both ma'am and sir, they have educated many students and given them a better future. So today we take the opportunity to discuss about this channel and let us know about what ma'am and sir have in their minds. I have a set of questions in my mind, which I assume every one of you also have in your minds. And so I have decided that I put up my questions in front of sir and madam. And I hope that by the end of this video, we'll have a clear outlook about what this channel is. So ma'am and sir, are you okay with it?
Yes.
Yeah. So before we start with any questions, we would like them to speak something about this channel.
This channel is about educating NEET and JEE. Aspirants, and it is useful for CBSE boards preparation also, and we want to reach wider audience who cannot afford to go for coaching and all.
Ma'am, would you like to say something?
Regarding this channel, it has been in our minds from many days to begin something which helps the students. So we just started, it's a first step that we have taken regarding the coaching of plus two as well as for boards and NEET. Okay, hope it would be helpful for all the children, whoever are preparing for the exam.
It really sounds very interesting to be true, and I really want to appreciate the efforts that you both have put into it and the idea that you came up with. I think your knowledge and the efforts that you have put together will help a lot of students, because many students have started using digital platforms for their learning. So I'm very excited to dig deeper into this discussion. So let's begin with my first question. You have somewhat answered my first question, but let me ask you once again. I'd like to know about the aim of this channel.
We got many things through teaching. We taught many students and we learned a lot by teaching the children. So ultimately teaching is not only educating people, getting educated self. So we got a lot, and it is the time to give it back. There are many students who are not able to go to the coaching centers and all. So as the lockdown happened, actually almost all the doors are closed, and the only way is digital platform. So that is why we want to reach a wider audience, or at least few people are benefited through this channel, will be happy, and that is our aim. It is mostly service oriented. We are not wishing to get it back, but we want to give to the children or students who are really aspiring to learn better.
Sir, and when did you plan about this? Is it during the lockdown?
Yeah, we already had an idea of doing some surveys in some or the other way, but lockdown has given us a good opportunity to make a beginning. So during the lockdown, we had only one means of teaching the students, that is the digital platform. But later I felt this is more better, okay, which if it can reach many students, our purpose is done.
I completely think it is a very good idea, but why did you think it is a good idea to come up with such a channel to begin?
Okay, I feel it is helpful for children because being as a teacher, we are only reachable to a very few students whom we are teaching directly. But sometimes if they get a doubt and they want to review it, I feel internet or this YouTube channel would be the best way, okay, so that they can revise it even before the exam. At least a few concepts which they are not very clear in the class, listening again may give them some clarity. That is one point. Second is reachability is also more, because nowadays everybody is on internet. Okay, they want information is of course available everywhere, but whenever they want any clarity on a particular topic, I hope this channel will be helpful.
As you mentioned, that information is available almost everywhere nowadays. So I'd like to ask Sir this time, how do you both think this channel will be different from the other channels which are already available on YouTube or in other social media platforms? How do you think it's going to benefit the students?
Yeah, there are many channels available, and if I have to answer in a single word, it is completeness. Suppose if you refer the YouTuber or any other website, you will get in bits and pieces, like a particular topic or a particular example, or it is limited to a particular thing, but it gives completeness. Like we want to cover the entire syllabus, so that whatever they want, they can view. Like it is a self-learning kind of thing. So right from beginning till the end, you can rely on this channel and learn completely. So it gives 100%. 100% means 100% learning experience. As if you feel like going to a particular person for tuition or attending it physically. Okay, so that means we want to give complete content. All the topics will be covered so that they can benefit more. So whenever they want, they can readily log on to our channel and learn that particular topic. Okay.
Sir, as you already mentioned, it is like a tuition. It's like a tuition, but is it a tuition which is also free? Because people pay for the tuitions, but for your channel, the students need not pay any extra amount. So it's like a tuition for free, is it?
Yes.
That's right.
Yeah, we don't want to charge anything. Only the charges they have to bear is the internet charges.
Yeah.
Now I don't think it's a problem. It is available in every nook and corner.
Yeah. Ma'am, this time I'll come back to you again. And ma'am, please let us know about the subjects that you both are going to include.
Right now, we have begun with physics and chemistry. Okay, we want to give all first and second year complete, starting from basics till they prepare for NEET and whatever is needed for NEET and JEE. So, right now, we are doing physics and chemistry.
What about maths and biology?
At present, we don't have maths and biology. We are looking for it. If we get a right person in future, maybe we will also add maths and biology.
Who are willing to work with us, who have a service orientation, if they have a good intention to help the students,
yeah.
Then we want to rope in those lecturers also. Definitely, in future,
yeah, there's
maths and biology also will bring in.
Sir, who do you think is going to benefit from this videos? Like, what kind of a student? Because there are students who have better grasping
different,
power,
different
understanding levels.
Yes.
So there are some students who require a little bit more explanation than few others.
Mm-hmm.
So who are which is the group of students it is targeted to?
I think it will benefit everyone. We are doing the videos in such a manner that it benefits all. But if you ask this question specifically, it will be useful for average, below average kind of students also. Absolutely beginners who don't have any prior knowledge. And as I told you, this is a self-learning kind of tool. So they can begin with zero knowledge. And they can go up to a level. It is even good for average, above average students, good students also. Who are not clear about the concepts in the classroom, or not finding a right kind of book, then they can utilize. Sometimes they can watch a video and learn from it. So even it is useful for good students also. I think for outstanding students who are aiming very high, who are toppers, it may not be useful for those students. Okay. So except that, most of the students, I think they'll benefit from this channel.
So sir, you mean that this is a very basic kind of a teaching where every student will
almost
benefit.
Because the bulk of the students are average, below average,
yeah.
Most average students. Outstanding students are very few. It is aimed for average, above average student.
Which means that even the average students and the below average students, they won't feel that they are excluded.
So they can completely learn
from it.
Yes.
And since they can watch the videos again and again, it means that they can take as much time
as
they require
to
learn.
Yes.
Okay. Sir and ma'am, you both said that it is useful for NEET and JEE aspirants. So is it also aimed at helping those preparing for JEE Advanced?
Regarding JEE Advanced, right now we started from the basic level so that it helps for boards as well as for NEET and even for JEE. I've included a few numericals also which are often repeated in NEET and JEE. But coming to Advanced, they have to go in depth or into the subject. Right now we are not directly aiming for JEE Advanced students. But let us see, depending on the demand, if children need any particular topic, then definitely we.
Which means that students can contact
you. They can just put the comment
if
they need any particular topic or clarity on any numerical, we are always there to help them out.
So
it all depends on the response given by the students. If they give good response and if they demand something,
then we'll definitely
we are happy
to
help.
Which means that comments and doubts are most welcome. How many lectures have you uploaded till now?
We started with second year syllabus first. Physics, almost it is the end. We have come to the end of the chapters. Soon we will start even first year also.
Okay.
So, even chemistry also, few chapters already we have prepared.
So, you said that you started this channel 6 months back. As I can remember.
Mm-hmm.
So how did you begin it with?
We first began with the second year syllabus. Regarding physics, almost all the chapters of second years I have covered starting from basic till the JEE level. Then first year, soon we will.
And ma'am, what is the sequence of the videos that you are uploading? Are you considering a particular chapter?
Yes. I am just following the chapter sequence just like the NCERT textbook. Whatever is the order of the NCERT, I have followed the same. But in every chapter, I have taken them to a level which is needed for objective.
Okay. And which means that do you dedicate one video for one chapter?
No. It is not a single video. Each video I made it as half an hour. Sometimes when numericals are there, it may be more than that. But for each chapter, there are around 30 videos, depending on the length of the chapter.
Okay.
Sometimes it's 20.
Yeah. How often do you both plan to upload the videos? Or how often did you upload?
Actually, we uploaded a few videos. I'm talking about chemistry.
Yeah.
So one chapter is already uploaded. I kept in private, but soon I'll make it public. And so for now, we are uploading in batches, 4 or 5 videos at a time like that. So that we'll get feedback from the children. And in future, I'm planning to upload 2 to 3 videos per week. It all depends. As of now, we got more time to prepare videos. But in future, we'll be having our own duties, no? Apart from it, we have to make the videos. So, at least I hope I can upload at least 2 videos per week. And that is my plan. So, they are in a sequential manner only. Until I finish a chapter, I'll not proceed to other chapter. Okay.
And sir, how many chapters did you already upload by now?
I did only one chapter. But the content is ready for more chapters, 5-6 chapters are already dead. So after training and doing the editing part,
yeah,
I'll upload one by one slowly. So it is a like a long process only, like within another 5-6 months I can complete second year.
Sir, and have you also, like ma'am, started with second year, first chapter of chemistry?
Yeah, of course, I did. Yeah,
you both are maintaining the sequence, like first you are going with the second year
second
syllabus,
year.
Starting from the sequence that is in the NCERT books.
Yes.
Okay, and then you will carry on with the first year.
First year from next academic year, I think we can do
yeah.
it from March or so.
From March, huh.
So it will be useful for next batch students.
Yeah, yeah. This time I'll come to a more direct question. So do you think that this channel and the videos that you will upload or you have already uploaded, is it a complete replacement of the offline classes?
No. That is a straightforward answer. Because we cannot replicate the classroom teaching exactly in the video. So we are trying our level best, but somehow it is useful.
Yeah.
Like if there is no alternative, like if they cannot go to the classroom, who are residing in remote areas, or who cannot afford to go for coaching centers, it will be beneficial for those students. So if there is no alternative, definitely it is useful. And moreover, they need not to spend much time in referring different books, because these videos are well researched. Like before doing a video, we have to go through the content. So it saves a lot of time for the students who watch these videos. So I don't say, but still I don't say it is a complete replacement for classroom teaching. Okay.
Sir, how are you planning to reach or help the students? Like what are the things that you're putting into the video or you're planning to put into the video in the future? Like examples are like giving them assignments and all. What do you think about those?
That is definitely needed, because only watching the video, it isn't enough. Okay, so once the concept is clear through the video, they have to practice the questions. So we are planning to add some more assignments and what they have to do after completing the video soon along with the video lectures. Like if they watch a particular topic, on that topic, what are the set of questions they are supposed to practice? If any doubts they get, we are always there to help them.
So not only the assignments and explanations you will find in this channel, we want to prepare the PDF files, or if it is possible, handwritten notes also we want to provide for the students, and they can access through the link that is provided in the description box.
Yeah,
later on we will do, that is also of course takes some time.
We will, definitely.
Definitely we will do it. Because watching video alone may not be
complete.
That, it is helpful definitely, but it will not give complete learning experience.
Yeah.
So they have to put their own effort also regarding this. Okay, so.
And I'd also like to ask that you, after every video, at the end of the videos, do you put up questions like question and answers? Do you solve question and answers?
I have done a few numericals also, because physics application is a must.
Yeah.
It is not just learning and then leaving it. So applications, I have done a few important model questions for every chapter. But apart from that, assignments will be a substitute.
And ma'am, how do you think this questions that you have picked up will be beneficial for the students? Like, have you picked it up from different sources?
Yes. I have picked it from mostly from previous year questions, previous models which were already covered, and the way in which the question can be asked, like based on de Broglie's concept, how many different ways the question can be given. So we have touched each and every model of the question. Okay, so some few more questions will be discussed.
Please tell me and the viewers about the mode that you are using to teach them. Like, are you using board or PowerPoint, something like that?
Traditional method is more trusted method. Like Blackboard chat
Definitely.
Method is the more trusted method. Most of the lectures we used that only. But apart from it, we used pen paper method also. Like for doing for numericals, we used pen paper method, and even PowerPoint also. Sometimes it is required to give only raw information, where you don't require to explain much, because it involves only information, no concept. So in that case, we can simply present it by using a PowerPoint.
Yeah.
So we use PowerPoint presentation, pen paper method, and Blackboard chat. So that involves complete video, Blackboard chat.
So do you mean that a single video comprises of like, can comprise of one or two modes?
No. Depending on the topic. Like sometimes when concepts are involved, it is better on pen paper. I mean, on the board.
Sometimes you continue a whole video by your PPT, or sometimes you use the board. Based on what kind of discussion is required.
Yes, yes, on the content kind of topic. Yes.
Yeah, that is a very good approach actually, because even though PowerPoint learning is the new method, it still does not cover everything, and it is still not even close to how the traditional method of this teaching is. What technical equipments are you using to record the videos?
Right now we are going with the basic things what we have, but hope so in future we may go with the live board and including some animations, okay, wherever experiments are required, animations also will be used regarding physics, regarding chemistry.
Definitely molecular models and all we use. In digital platform, animation has a lot of importance. As of now, we don't have much knowledge about animation.
Yeah.
We have to rely on other animators to do it.
Yeah.
So that is why right now we are not using any animations also. So we use animations. And coming to the equipment, we have ordinary mobile phone only. So I think it will not hamper the quality of the video. So for now, I think it is satisfactory, but feedback is welcome. If the viewers are not satisfied with the content or this technical aspects like clarity and resolution, they can report to us. So that in future, we'll invest. Right now, we are not investing much money into it. So to procure
all, improvise
it. In future, definitely we will go a little bit ahead.
You are also not starting this for any commercial.
It is not.
It's completely kind of a charity right now. So I understand that you will not like to put so much of technical and things into it. These are the questions that I could think of. There might be something else that the viewers might want to know. And is it okay if they comment and ask you?
Definitely.
Yeah, sure.
They can.
Yeah.
Feedback
is
welcome.
Yeah.
Most welcome. Any comments you can say.
Yeah, sure. And let me also add something to this. We have seen how dedicated both sir and madam have been. Their knowledge and the efforts that they have put into teaching us is completely amazing, and it deserves appreciation. And now that you have thought of something even more commendable, it's really good. I am feeling very happy as I'm asking you these questions. And I really hope this idea that you have come up with, it has a very, very good journey.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Hope so.
And also with digitalization, people using internet everywhere across the whole world, if you are planning to bring more students and help more people, I think this is amazing. And I wish both of you good luck. And is there anything else you want to add?
If it reaches many people, that is the best part. What we can expect.
So share.
Yeah.
And
to the deserving people.
Deserving people, and also tell others about this, so that they can utilize it properly, and that will be more
satisfactory for
us.
For all the effort.
I really hope that those watching this video really help others by sharing this video, because I really feel that all the videos that ma'am and sir have been or will be uploading in the future will really help the student community a lot. So please do like, share and subscribe, and do keep on sharing it, and so that the students who are really in need of videos like this are benefited by it. And at the end, I would like to thank each one of you for watching this, and I'd also like to thank Sarah and Madam once again.
Pleasure.
Okay, bye-bye.